everybody. Everybody's so grumpy every morning around here.
Hate for you to have to suffer that.
And he's telling me about going out with a crush. Camper goes up in flames. Hi, welcome to Comedy Parenting Radio, the show that's single-handedly saving the planet by using Twizzlers for straws. Our number one listeners are coming from San Jose, California. We don't know who you are out there, but thanks for listening to Comedy Parenting Radio and getting your family and extended relatives to listen too.
It's probably your barber's third cousin's dog groomer.
Today's topic, we're going to be talking about foods that hurt.
We're going to go put on our face masks. We'll be right back.
Speak up, because you can. Your mind is a powerful tool, and so is your freedom of speech. So use it. It's what separates you from being a number to being an individual. Thoughts, beliefs, opinions, creativity. It's what makes you,
you.
Stand proud and say aloud. Know your rights. Know your freedom to speak. This message is brought to you by the National Association of Broadcasters, Education Foundation, and the Broadcast Education Association.
Comedy.
Parenting.
Radio.
I can't get ahead no matter how hard I try. I'm getting really good at barely getting by.
You're back with Comedy Parenting Radio. Foods that hurt. You know, normally food is supposed to be something that you like to eat and it's pleasant and it makes you feel better.
Well, that's correct, but that's not always the case.
No, it's not. So we came up with this list of foods that hurt.
Number one on the list, popcorn.
Tell me about how popcorn hurts.
Well, think about it. You're reaching into the popcorn bag or bowl, and you're getting near the bottom where all the popcorn kernels are, and you pick up a popcorn kernel on accident, and you try to, and you go up for a bite, and you start chewing it up, and then you go...
Oh, and you crunch your tooth on the popcorn kernel.
Did you know that 9 out of 10 doctor's visits can be prevented by stop eating popcorn?
It's true. And not only does it hurt you with the seeds, what about the little kernels that get stuck in between your teeth and your gums?
And you can't even get dental floss underneath it.
I don't even know what you do to get it out of there.
You get a sandblaster.
Can't get it. So yeah, popcorn, number one on the list.
Are you sure that's number one or is that number 10? I never can tell. Why don't you put this side up on our list? Seriously.
Well, it's because we write in Chinese Hebrew shorthand. So it comes out upside down, backwards, and is an actual picture. Sort of a hieroglyphic thing. Did you see that little picture of a tooth?
Didn't one of the famous pharaohs die from one of his wisdom teeth?
No, that was King Tut. He was eating popcorn.
What?
Blackberry preserves. Old-fashioned, homemade.
Yeah, they're another one of those things that gets stuck in your teeth, and then it just hurts when you chew. Like, there's so much pressure between your teeth.
I read that it takes like 50,000 pounds per square inch to actually break a blackberry seed.
Holy cow.
Yeah, so lots of people lose their fillings when eating blackberry preserves.
And one of the worst parts is when they get kind of stuck up in between the gum and the tooth, and you have a loose-ish tooth.
I would like to point out that blackberry preserves are my very favorite all-time jelly or jam. So it's dangerous for you guys to eat. Don't try it at home. Send your preserves to me.
Yes, we would hate for you to have to suffer that.
No, I'll take care of it for you.
I think I know the third thing on our list.
What would that be?
Captain Crunch.
Oh, Captain Crunch, it's the worst, isn't it?
It's not...
I don't think we'll get to use that one.
That's not what I meant to say.
No, but there we go. Okay. Stay tuned. We had a faux pas that we couldn't put on the air, so we'll be right back.
Howdy, all of you kings, lords, and pheasants. Are you being raided by Picts on Thursdays and Huns on Saturday nights?
If so, boy, have we got the solution for you.
Introducing Castle in a Box. A complete castle fortress complex in a box that you and your lady can set up in an afternoon. It comes with simple directions.
It's as easy as 1, 2, 3.
1,
you mow a big green square out on your lawn.
2,
you cut the box open with a sharp knife.
3,
you match up the colored tabs to the colored slits.
And 4,
you affix them together using the included Scottish tape. Here's a testimonial from one of our satisfied customers.
I ordered the castle in the box and set it up in one easy afternoon. I was able to keep the Viking ballet troupe at bay for 2 months until they got drapes and or tights and had to leave.
So order your box of Castle in a Box today.
Castle in a Box. Never accept substitutes.
Castle in a Box is not intended for usage in any areas with precipitation. Castle in a Box is not effective against ratkeen and sword. Castle in a Box may actually attract rodents. Do not attempt to barbecue in your backyard while using Castle in a Box. Colorblind people should not order Castle in a Box unless recommended by their doctor. Side effects may include dizziness, nausea, and not being invited to real castles. Attempting to fight fire-breathing dragons while in Castle in a Box may void warranty.
This is Crazy Russian Dad. You're listening to Comedy Parenting Radio. In Soviet Russia, homework do you.
You know, it's not really Captain Crunch. It's Captain Sandpaper.
Oh, my word. You know, if you sit down and eat about 10 bowls of Captain Crunch with the crunch berries, it rips up the roof of your mouth. Terrible. It's just like you have, like, skin hanging off the roof of your mouth like stalactites.
I'm surprised there hasn't been a lawsuit yet.
Good point.
It's a lot like Kix.
It's just as bad as Reese's Pieces cereal.
This show is not being brought to you by General Mills.
You know, food is supposed to be like soft and make you feel better and like
fluffy and cold like Jell-O, you know?
I got something that's soft and fluffy and hurts.
And what would that be?
Marshmallows.
How in the world could that possibly hurt?
I mean, yeah, how can a marshmallow actually hurt?
Haven't you ever eaten a flaming marshmallow, Dad?
All the marshmallows I do on the campfire are flaming.
I rest my case.
And here I thought that the only way that you could feel bad from eating marshmallows was if you ate too many of them.
No, and I guess he's right about that. Not only does it hurt when you pull the flaming part off with your hand and shove it in your mouth, then you get this black sticky stuff all over your clothes.
Uh-huh.
You climb in your sleeping bag and there's black sticky goo everywhere.
I have a revolutionary idea for that to not happen.
What would that be?
Blow out the marshmallow before you eat it.
What fun is that?
Seriously, what fun is that? Like, it's like all the most fun, like if a bear attacks you, you can shove the marshmallow down its throat.
Yeah, there's great safety in flaming marshmallows. For those of you who do like golden brown marshmallows, you will not be safe if a bear attacks.
Well, it's probably more fun than spending your night in the hospital.
Plus, you can have that long stick. You can fling flaming marshmallows over at the other campsite for playing the music too loud.
Mm-hmm. That's my favorite part, actually.
Hey, hold it down over there, you guys.
My camper! Ooh. My cabbage is in my camper!
Camper goes up in flames. Okay, you kids pack up the tent, quick.
Put it on top of the van. Well, I've got the next thing on our list.
Okay, what would be another food that's painful?
Watermelon.
How in the world is watermelon going to be painful? I mean, it's sweet, juicy, watery. Maybe it drips a little bit.
It's like the exact opposite of flaming marshmallows, you know?
Yeah, but how does it hurt?
Haven't you ever gotten into a seed spitting contest?
Yes.
And
pretty much every time we ever eat watermelons outside.
Especially where you're the judge and then you miscall something and then they turn on you and start spitting seeds at you?
And this is the worst part is when they do the machine gun seed spitting.
How do they do that?
They save up like 30 seeds in their mouth and then they go.
Yeah, I hate that. They're spitting them in my ears, in my eyes, down my. Yeah,
that hurts.
That's a good point. That's a good point.
Up your nose?
We'll try the seedless watermelons next time. Instead of like air guitar, it'll be air seed spitting. We have neglected to say the most obvious thing.
What's that?
Jalapenos.
Hold on. Like the ghost pepper, the kale and the reaper. Andale, andale, andale.
Why do you have to go fast? Leche, leche, leche.
Milk, milk, milk.
Yeah.
Because, macho, you got to get to the water fast.
People have different tolerances, but, you know, jalapenos and then pretty much any kind of peppers that are spicy.
Yeah, basically.
Like, those things hurt.
I generally have a very high heat tolerance.
There's one place that stuff don't hurt at all.
Where's that?
Taco Bell.
Oh, yeah, Taco Bell. Wow, get the fire sauce. It's like mustard.
Yeah, pretty much.
Foods that hurt. Comedy Parenting Radio. Stay tuned.
Chile Rebelde me pediste. Chile Rebelde te daré. Vámonos para la vuelta. Cuando ya te lo contaré.
Tell them what it means, kid.
You want green peppers?
Sí.
I give you green peppers. Come out to the garden.
I don't believe it. My savings are gone. They're gone.
You're kidding.
Nope, they're gone. They're gone, gone.
Okay, all right. Think about it. Where did you have them last?
I remember I was home, then I took them, and then I spent them on that vacation to Aruba. Then I bought this miniature suit of armor I saw in the in-flight magazine.
And that's the last you saw of your savings?
Yes.
This is so weird.
I know, right?
Weird? Not really. Not saving now means no money later. You'd be surprised how quickly a little money from every paycheck can really add up. Put away a few bucks, feel like a million bucks. For free ideas and easy ways to save, go to feedthepig.org. That's
feedthepig.org.
The armor is cool, though. Oops. I think I broke its gauntlet.
You broke my favorite part.
This message brought to you by the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants and the Ad Council.
You're listening to Comedy Parenting.
Stop imitating Fezzik, and I mean it.
Does anybody want to do that?
What else hurts?
Corn dogs.
Why would a corn dog hurt? I mean, it's kind of like this breaded thing. You know, it's got a little hot doggy thing in it there.
What's the problem is when you don't chew it enough and it just slides down your throat slowly and you're
talking about most people choke on a hot dog, and this is even worse because it has the breading on it.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's, I've had many a close call.
This is 911. What's your emergency?
My babysitter's choking on a corn dog.
Do you know the Heimlich maneuver?
No, but I'm pretty good at karate.
And I can do the five positions in ballet.
I can do the Fosbury flop.
I'm sorry, was that the Fosbury flop you said?
Pufferfish.
What made you think of pufferfish?
Elijah was over there with his cheeks inflated. So, like, don't Japanese eat pufferfish, right?
I thought pufferfish was poisonous.
It is. You have to cook it a special way. By the way, don't try this at home. And don't even try it anywhere. And don't eat it at a restaurant. You know, those crazy Japanese, they're always eating poisonous things, you know?
Ah, what is poisonous that we can eat from the ocean and might not die if we cook it correctly?
Well, the thing is, if what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. That's the reason why they eat so many poisonous things.
I don't think they read Nietzsche.
Who?
Nietzsche.
Bless you.
When you're going out with your crush and you're at their house, and they're like, yeah, you strong, you're not obese.
Excuse me a second. How old are you?
He is currently 11 years old.
And he's telling me about going out with a crush?
Yes.
No, it's the painful part.
The only crush he's ever gone out with was a soda.
Okay, continue the crush idea.
It hurt me. And you're walking around, and suddenly your stomach bulges out, and you look like you're incredibly fat. It is because of the pufferfish you just ate.
You know, I think he really does know how this stuff works.
Yeah, he's got everything more figured out than I do.
So don't even eat a live pufferfish, everyone.
Puffer sushi. No, you're supposed to cook it. There's a category of food that hurts.
Like, what's that? How can you have an entire category of food that hurts?
Survival foods that you find out in the woods. Thistles, cactus, red ants, and pufferfish. No, not pufferfish. You've been listening to Comedy Parenting Radio, Foods That Hurt. Thanks for coming up in the studio today, guys.
You're welcome.
You're very welcome.
We better get out of here so I can go make you guys some peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. Bye-bye.
Well, haven't you ever gotten to a speed sitting? I really can't talk at night.
A watermelon speed sitting contest? Yes, I have.
Haven't you ever gotten into
a Swede spitting? It's this little Swedish guy spitting.
Haven't you ever gotten into a speed sitting?